So, nakita po natin ang ating screen. Alright. So, let me know if there are any issues sa audio and the video. So, welcome po sa ating sector devotional. Surprise po, ako mag-preach. Ako rin na surprise. Okay, so let's begin. I just thought of continuing yung lessons natin the past few Sundays. Diba? Last May, we had a lesson on inspired by things that matter. So we had a lesson titled Focus on Things That Matter, that we should throw off distractions and pursue what matters. And the main point is that, you know, we have regrets when we put inconsequential yung distractions before what is important or the things that matter. And last June, we had a lesson titled Distracted by Fear. And we talked about different kinds of fear and that we need to overcome our fear. And just this August, last August 11th, we talked about a lesson titled Distracted by Wounds. And to overcome this distraction, we talked about how we need to remember that we are refreshed by God and we are perfected by God and encouraged by God. So tonight, to continue with the topic of distractions, the title of our lesson tonight is Distracted by Pursuit of Happiness. Okay. Bago tayo magpatuloy, let's go to God in prayer. Let's pray. Panginoon, maraming salamat po sa time na to that we could talk about the scriptures, we could evaluate our lives, and that we could make decisions on things we need to change. God, I pray, Father, that you please be with me as I share the message tonight. Please grant me the wisdom and the strength to preach your word. And I pray that tulungan niyo po sana yung mga puso namin na mas maging handa at maintindihan ang mensahe para sa amin. At tulungan niyo po kami na gumawa ng desisyon para mamuhay ng tama, Father. God, help us to understand your message for us tonight. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Okay, let me just check on the messages. All right. Okay. Medyo mahina yung volume ko daw. Is there a problem? Maybe I can code error. Is this better now? Can you hear
better, me? Better, yeah.
Okay, sige. I will just lean forward. sige. So, the pursuit of happiness can be a distraction sa buhay natin. How can that be a distraction? Happiness nga siya. Well, notice that yung word na happiness is enclosed in quotation marks. Why? Well, from the book, Joshua Becker says this. We human beings have confused the pursuit of happiness with the pursuit of self. As a result, we think we'll be happiest if we focus on ourselves and meet our own needs and desires, sometimes even at the expense of others. So, ang problema natin, there's nothing wrong per se with the pursuit of happiness. Except that, nagkakamali tayo sa pagkakaintindi, that we think that happiness is focusing on ourselves. The pursuit of self and the pursuit of lasting happiness are not the same. But this is what the society around us teaches, na para maging masaya, kailangan nagagawa mo lahat ng gusto. But that's not what happiness is. In fact, most of the time, opposite siya. The first point I want to share with us tonight is this. Pursuit of self does not lead to happiness. Yung pag-pursue or paggawa, ang pag-focus sa mga bagay na para sa sarili lang natin, it's not the meaning of happiness. Pero yun yung natural tendency natin. And for me, that's my natural tendency. You know, serving ourselves comes naturally. Yung unahin ng sarili, yung natural para sa atin. Pero when we try to focus on ourselves, we might be happy for a little bit, pero hindi yun yung pangmatagalan na kaligayahan. merong pleasure na nagbibigay sa atin in the short run, pero in the long run, hindi siya talaga tumatagal. And the scripture actually talks about this a bit. Sabi sa Matthew chapter 6, verse 33, "Seek the kingdom of God above all else and live righteously, and He will give you everything you need." First of all, si Jesus nagsasalita dito and He's telling us, ano ba dapat yung hinahabol natin? What should we pursue? What should we seek? Because what we seek or what we pursue matters. If we seek the kingdom of God first, sabi sa scripture, and if we live righteously, God will give us everything that we need. I think the word everything, kasi lahat yun, di ba? Everything. That includes happiness. When we seek the kingdom first, God gives us happiness. And besides, di ba? If you have everything that you need, kung lahat ng kailangan mo, meron ka, hindi ba tayo magiging happy nun? Yes. And to be happy, to have everything that we need, we just have to seek the kingdom above all else and live righteously. Sabi rin sa Ecclesiastes chapter 2, verse 26, "To the person who pleases him, God gives wisdom, knowledge, and happiness. But to the sinner, He gives the task of gathering and storing up wealth to hand it over to the one who pleases him." So, sabi dito, God gives happiness to the person who pleases. And a lot of times in the scripture, we can see that happiness, the best kind, the kind of happiness that lasts, comes from God. Binibigay siya ng Diyos. Happiness is something we receive, tinatanggap natin, nakukuha natin mula sa Diyos. Yung pinakamagandang klase ng happiness. It's not something for us to get for ourselves, but something we receive from God. Happiness is a gift from God, not a goal in life. Pero that's what most people want, di ba? Yun yung goal nila. I want to be happy. That's my goal in life. But you see, happiness is never intended to be a goal. Happiness is the result of having the right life. Because happiness is a gift from God. If God does not give us true and lasting happiness, we will never achieve it. Sabi ni Viktor Frankl, a psychologist, sabi niya, "Happiness cannot be pursued. It must ensue." So, ang happiness daw hindi pwedeng habulin. It must ensue. Ano pag sabi ng ensue? The word ensue means it happens or occurs afterwards. Something na nangyayari pagkatapos. Something that happens after. It's a result of something. So happiness is a result. Sabi rin natuloy natin. And it does so as the unintended side effect of one's personal dedication to a cause greater than oneself, or as the byproduct of one's surrender to a person other than oneself. The Frankl's, explains, and I agree, the Bible supports what he's saying, na yung happiness ay isang bagay na natanggap natin pag meron tayong buhay natin ay binubuhas natin sa isang bagay na mas mahalaga, mas malaki kaysa sa atin. Like today, we celebrate Inoy Aquino Day. It is known for his statement that the Filipino is worth dying for. Now, regardless what your politics may be, we have to agree that yung desisyon niya na bumalik kahit na there's a risk to his life because he wants to serve the Filipino people is heroic. He believed in a cause greater than himself. And sa mga bayani na we honor pag may holidays, di ba ganoon naman sila lahat? They believe in a cause greater than themselves. So let's pursue purpose and allow happiness to us. Now, some might say, well, that's from the Bible. I mean, do we have any evidence na yung happiness ay hindi makukuha sa pag-focus sa sarili? Well, psychologists have done a lot of studies. There is what I like to call the Monopoly study. Sino ba sa atin marunong maglaro ng Monopoly? But basically, researchers at the University of California sa Berkeley, nagkaroon sila ng study. So yung mga participants sa study nila, pinaglaro nila ng Monopoly. Pero dinaya nila yung laro in such a way, it was rigged, so that may isang tao na mapapanalunan niya karamihan dun sa pera. Kasi yung purpose ng yung laro Monopoly is padamihan ng property, padamihan ng pera. So, dinaya nila yung laro in such a way na may isang tao na sa kanya mapupunta karamihan pera at yung property. Ang purpose ng mga researchers, gusto lang makita ano ba ang magiging epekto sa tao pag gano'n lang nangyari. And this is, you know, so in-observe nila yung participants habang naglalaro sila ng Monopoly. What did they find? They noticed that yung mga participants na nanalo, na marami silang nakuha dun sa game, they became more dominant, parang ang lakas ng dating, and they began to look down on yung kalaban nila sa laro. And yung pati yung snacks, mas malakas silang ubus ng snacks. And they said, ito yung nakuha nilang conclusion from the study. Wealth, kahit malaro lang yan, tends to make people A, less generous, gusto nilang kainin lahat yung snacks, and B, more isolated, mas makasarili. And both generosity and relational connectedness are strongly associated with happiness. So, sabi nung kuha ng study, pinapakita nito ang dahilan why may mga tao na yumayaman pero nagiging mas malungkot. Because wealth does not bring happiness. In fact, meron ng study na nauna pa dito more than 2,000 years ago. And that's the study done by Solomon, the Ecclesiastes. Sabi niya in Ecclesiastes 5, 10, and 12, whoever loves money never has enough. Whoever loves wealth is never satisfied with their income. This too is meaningless. The sleep of a laborer is sweet, whether they eat little or much. But as for the rich, their abundance permits them no sleep. Kasi sabi ni Solomon, yung pinakamayamang hari na whoever lived. Sabi niya, habang dumadami yung pera, mas lalong pakiramdam mo kulang siya. You are never satisfied. Money does not bring happiness because it doesn't satisfy. You think if you have more, you will be happy, you will be satisfied, but it doesn't work that way. And buti pa daw yung ordinary panggagawa. Kahit konti lang yung ari-arian niya, at least nakatulong siya ng mahimbing. Samantalang yung maraming ari-arian, natatakot na ba kami magnakaw sa kanyang abundance? So wealth does not bring happiness, even according to the study of Solomon. What about success and fame? Now, for many of us, maybe sa involved or sa singles, we dream of being successful, we dream of being famous. But there is this study sa University of Rochester sa New York. In-evaluate nila yung goals of happiness ng mga 147 college graduates. Kasi in-evaluate nila 1 year after graduation, kumusta na ba sila? And then a year after that, kumusta na yung goals nila of success and fame? Ang naging resulta was this. Those who attained wealth and fame goals were less happy. So, kung sino pa yung nakamit nila yung goal nila of success and fame, sila pa yung hindi masaya. Then those who achieved more intrinsic goals such as personal growth, enduring relationships, and helping in the community. So, yung pag-personal na goals, hindi naging masaya. Pero yung mga goals nila para sa iba, tumulong sa community, sila pa yung mas naging masaya. Bakit? Because high achievers felt they were living their lives in ways predetermined by others. So ito yung tingin na, well, the basis for success. So parang hindi talaga para sa kanila. But those who had more intrinsic goals were happier. And again, si Solomon, nauna na siya sa study na to. Even in Ecclesiastes, he explained, I increased my achievements, so I became great and surpassed all who were before me in Jerusalem. When I considered all that I had accomplished and what I had labored to achieve, I found everything to be futile in a pursuit of the wind. There was nothing to be gained under the sun. This is in Ecclesiastes chapter 2, verse 4, 9, and 11. Alam naman natin ang story ni Solomon. Nakuha niya lahat ng gusto niya na marami siyang na-achieve. Actually, in between verses, sa verses 5 to 8 ng Ecclesiastes, doon nakalista doon yung mga accomplishments niya na walang katulad. But sabi ni Solomon, all those achievements, nothing siya, it's meaningless. What we can learn from Solomon's experience is this. Happiness that is based on achievements does not last. You know, just like trophies, yung mga trophy, mga medals, maganda yan. You know, we just finished the Olympics. But actually, over time, makakalimutan din naman yan. Right? They get old, they lose their glimmer. If we base our happiness on achievements, we will not be happy. At least not for a long time. What about work? No, sabi sa Ecclesiastes chapter 2, verse 22 to 23, the Holman version, Solomon writes, "For what does a man get with all his work and all his efforts that he labors at under the sun? For all his days are filled with grief and his occupation is sorrowful. Even at night, his mind does not rest. This too is futile." You know, now I've been working for, I don't know, decades now. And I know sometimes we try to find happiness at work. I remember being a fresh graduate, having my first job, and it makes you happy. Oh, I got a dream job. I'm gonna be happy now because I have the job, but I have the work that I want. But if that's the goal, it won't really last. And when I speak of work, it could refer to yung jobs natin, our careers. It could refer to our schoolwork. Tayo yung nasa university or sa high school pa lang. Sometimes I think people want to excel in work because maybe yung situation sa bahay, sa relationship with family, maybe it's not so great. And we try to make work our source of happiness. But the problem is, if work is the end goal, kung yun yung goal, happiness at work, it will not bring happiness. If we only work for a salary, it will not bring us. Paki-mute po. Salamat. Diba? I remember, if I didn't plan on sharing this, but naalala ko lang right now as I'm sharing. There was a time I worked full-time for the church. And I thought, diba, that's probably the greatest job in the world, to be, you know, to work full time for the church. But there came a point in that time that I was an intern to church that I realized I wasn't happy anymore. Part of that was because I was just motivated. It's just a job to me. It's a salary. You see, no matter how great the job is, even if it's working for the church, if you're just doing it for the salary or you're doing it for the grades, school, it will not bring us lasting happiness. We have to work for something greater than ourselves. Sabi nga dito sa John chapter 6, verse 27 in the NIV, Jesus says this, "Do not work for food that spoils, but for food that endures eternal life, which the Son of Man will give you." We should not work for things that don't last. Achievements, awards, promotion, salary. We should work for something that is eternal. Yung treasures in heaven. Yes, I'm not saying huwag tayo magtrabaho. What I'm saying is, the goal should be different. The reason, the motivation should be different. Kung titingnan natin yung Ecclesiastes chapter 2, if you read verse 18, kikita natin doon bakit hindi masaya si Solomon sa trabaho niya, sa achievements niya. Sabi niya doon sa verse 18, "I hated all my work that I labored at under the sun because I must leave it to the man who comes after me." And I realize si Solomon, there will come a time na iiwan niya rin lahat ng trabaho niya, mamamatay siya, hindi niya madadala lahat ng pinaghirapan niya. That's why Solomon was sad. That's why Solomon was upset. Because when he dies, he would lose everything that he worked for. You see, this is what happens when we work only for things on earth. But if we work for treasures in heaven, when we die, we will gain everything we have worked for. See the, how opposite it is? If we work for things on earth, when we die, we lose everything. But if we work for treasures in heaven, when we die, we gain everything. Another thing is beauty. A lot of people try to find happiness by looking beautiful or improving their appearance. According to a study that came out in Psychology Today in 2015, they determined that yung mga nag-engage in cosmetic surgery are actually very troubled. Those who were focused on making themselves beautiful to the point that they were willing to undergo surgery, they were very troubled. Those who had surgery were more likely to be more anxious or depressed and had a greater increase in these symptoms than non-patients. So being beautiful does not necessarily make you happy. And Solomon, earlier in his life, when he wrote the book of Proverbs, or collected the book of Proverbs, said the same thing. He said, charm is deceptive and beauty is fleeting, but a woman who fears the Lord is to be praised. Beauty, physical beauty, does not last. If our happiness is based on appearance, kung ano itsura natin, kung gaano tayo kagwapo, gaano tayo kaganda, then you can't be happy all the time kasi hindi ka naman palaging maganda, hindi ka naman palaging gwapo. And you won't be happy for very long kasi hindi naman tumatagal ang kagandang, you know, itsura, right? It won't last forever. And then Solomon added another one actually, which is pleasure. Sabi ni Solomon in Ecclesiastes 2 verse 1 to 2, I said to myself, come now, I will test you with pleasure to find out what is good. But that also proved to be meaningless. Laughter, I said, is madness. And what does pleasure accomplish? And I think this is the main thing that people believe. If I indulge in all the pleasures that I want, kung magawa ko lahat ng gusto ko, lahat ng luho ko, makuha ko, I will be happy. And that's what they live for every day. Diba? You see the Instagram posts, all the places they visited, lahat ng pagkain na nakain nila. You know, you see all the things that they share on social media and we think, ako rin kung ganyan din, kung makapunta ako dyan, kung makain ko yan, kung maka, you know, if I enjoy all these pleasures, I will also be happy. But Solomon already told us, way back thousands of years ago, I've been there, I've done that. I've indulged in every pleasure, but it doesn't bring happiness. What does pleasure accomplish? It's not beneficial for us to indulge our every desire. Solomon already experienced it for us para hindi na rin tayo disappoint when we try to do it ourselves. Some of us may not believe it, but remember, Solomon is the smartest man that ever lived, and this is what he experienced. You know, today, you know, we think sometimes that if I just binge watch more shows, if I shop more, kung makain ko lahat ng gusto ko, pagsugin ko yung sarili ko sa lahat ng mga buffet, or makatulog lang ako ng 24 oras, o makapagpahinga somewhere, o makapunta sa beach all the time, I will be happy. But the truth is, pleasure, the pursuit of pleasure, which is what the world teaches, will not bring lasting happiness. Yes, matutuwa tayo for a while. We will smile and laugh for a while, but it does not really last. It's not the kind of happiness that God wants us to have. In Matthew 25:21, in the parable of talents, Jesus said this. His master replied, well done, good and faithful servant. You have been faithful with a few things. I will put you in charge of many things. Come and share in your master's happiness. Real, when I read this, I noticed something for the first time. It's not the master giving happiness only to his servant, but it is sharing his happiness. Kung ano yung kasiyahan ng master, share niya dun sa kanyang servant. And that's how God is. God doesn't just give us happiness. He shares his own happiness with us. Can you imagine how happy God would be? And the kind of happiness that God, that Jesus, the Holy Spirit has, yan ang sinishare niya sa atin. See, real happiness is the one that God has. And that's the one that God wants to share with us. And to whom does God share his happiness with? Good and faithful servants. Which brings us to our second point. Pursue service. Happiness will follow. Pursue service. And happiness will follow. Pag nakafocus tayo sa paglilingkod, susunod na yung kasiyahan. The best and most direct pathway to lasting happiness and fulfillment is to not just look at our own interests, but also to look at the interests of others. When we live our lives for the sake of others, yung buhay natin mas magkakaroon ng value. And that's what brings us happiness. Now, what does the Bible say? In Proverbs 11, verse 25, it says, "The generous will prosper. Those who refresh others will themselves be refreshed." Now, I don't know about you, pero dito sa Pilipinas, we all want to be refreshed. Mainit ang panahon, di ba? Ang feeling na maging refreshed is the feeling of happiness. And the best way to be refreshed, according to the Bible, is to refresh others. Kung gusto mong maging masaya, focus on helping others be happy. That's what the Bible says. Don't try to suck all the happiness for yourself. Share it with others. And that's how you become happy. And this is a truth I had to learn early in my Christian life. When I was a campus student, my disciple told me, he said, you know, when I'm discouraged and I want to be encouraged, I focus on encouraging other people. And that principle stayed with me until today. Now, the best way to get encouraged is to encourage others first. And honestly, share ko lang sa inyo, that's one of my main reasons why I like to preach. I love to preach. Kasi when I focus on encouraging others when I preach, I feel myself being encouraged as well. Now, let me just share with you. When I got home today, I felt so tired. Simula na ng classes sa UP, I had classes today. When I got home, so tired. But I knew that when I started preaching tonight, dito sa Divo natin, I would feel refreshed. And that's how I feel right now. Wala na yung tiredness that I felt a while ago. Why? Because when you focus on refreshing others, you yourself will be refreshed. Sabi sa book, you know, becoming unselfish is not an intellectual exercise. You don't just think yourself into unselfishness. It's not even an act, like writing a check to a charity. Unselfishness is a quality you acquire only when you go and do something for others. The doing creates the being. You go from choosing to serve to be a servant. I like that. We start with choosing to serve, but eventually you become a servant. And what do the studies show as well? Adolescents, and I've seen maraming videos on this no, sa Instagram. I like sharing it with my kids for obvious reasons. But according to the book, according to studies, adolescents' household chores can have significant implication on the teen's positive well-being as they contribute to something greater than themselves. Now, parents, huwag naman natin pilitin yung mga teens na mag-go on a chores. Let's explain why it's good for them and how it really encourages them in the long run. Self-serving actions feel good when they are being carried out but do not support positive effects in the long run. Conversely, selfless action, even something as simple as cheering up a friend, showed the opposite pattern, a long-term positive effect. So, yung mga selfish actions, yan, papasaya ko for a while, pero walang long-term effect. But when you serve others and you make others happy, there's a long-term positive effect. Merong another study sa Columbia University. Yung mga investigators doon, the researchers, they wanted to find out if helping other people with their emotional well-being also benefited the helpers, yung tumutulong. Pag tumulong ko ba emotionally sa ibang tao, matutulungan ka rin ba emotionally? So they conducted a study using an anonymous online platform. Yung mga participants, they shared stories about their stressful life events, and then they provide emotional support to the other participants by giving feedback, advice, encouragement. So ano naging outcome ng study na to? Participants who engaged more by helping others instead of just receiving support, sila yung nagtutulong, nagbibigay ng support, they showed greater decreases in depression. And by helping others, we may enhance our own regulatory skills and emotional well-being. So the summary is, encouraging emotional recovery in others help us improve our own emotional health. So that's interesting, though. If we're struggling with our own emotional health, one of the best ways we can improve it is if we help others with their own emotional struggles. You know, selfless living results in greater overall life satisfaction. You want to be satisfied with your life? Be more selfless. Just this exact opposite of what our society teaches. But that's what the Bible teaches. Sabi sa 1 Corinthians 10:24, no one should seek their own good, but the good of others. Sabi ni Jesus, but love your enemies and do good and lend, expecting nothing in return, and your reward will be great. You know, we see this theme being repeated frequently in the Bible, giving of ourselves to others. And there are many examples of serving. Hindi naman kailangan malaki. Maraming mga maliliit na simple lang na mga paraan. We just have to start with some or any act of service para lang masimulang matalo natin yung selfishness. If we're struggling with selfishness, the best way to kill that is by start serving in some way. You know, there are many ways we can serve. Here are just a few examples. You know, by being hospitable to visitors. Now, you know, this week, we'll have house church services. They have new friends. Let's be hospitable. When we go back to having church services as a whole, we can encourage those who are visiting. And we have a lot of people visiting our services every Sunday. We could listen to a friend who is troubled, you know. Kung may nakita tayong medyo malungkot or di natin nakikita madalas, we can find out how they're doing. And you don't have to disciple. You can just listen. You can just encourage that way. Or maybe meron tayong mga kasama sa church na nahihirapan mag-quiet time. Let's have a quiet time with them. Or we have a lot of activities in church that we have different committees. You can join a committee, di ba? Or we can pray for people. So what we can do is you could ask for prayer requests. You know, ask brothers and sisters, what can I pray for? So by praying for them, you are serving them. And I like the fact that we have many members and nagdadala ng pagkain as well when we have meetings of the body. We can continue doing that. For me, my act of service is really preaching. Just this week, share ko lang, you know, this week has been challenging kasi simula na ng classes and have to prepare for class and I have a number of papers I need to do. I have, you know, so much to do this week. Kaso nung Sunday, Christian told me na wala pang mag-preach for this Wednesday because he was supposed to go to Mindoro. So, sige, I volunteered. And part of me, I didn't want to volunteer kasi I know na wala akong time to prepare for a lesson tonight. But I also know in my heart, I need to serve. So I denied myself. I said, bro, I'll do the preaching. This is one way. This is how I try to serve. And for us, we have a lot of different ways we can serve. But the last one there is donating to or participating in our outreach program. Nabanggit na kanina ni Jethro, pero this Saturday, we have this outreach program and you can serve by donating mga bagay na kailangan nila or by volunteering to go as well. If you want to know more details, just contact si Princess Bronte. You know, Becker says this, when we shift our focus on ourselves, off ourselves, we live lives of greater meaning and greater contribution. When we serve others without concern over what we might receive in return, we experience the beauty of selfless love. When we, sabi niya, pag gumagawa tayo, tumutulong tayo na hindi tayo naghahanap ng kapalit. Gusto lang natin tumulong. Doon nagkakaroon ng mas malaking contribution at meaning yung buhay natin. We experience the beauty of selfless love. And when we do that, we're just imitating Jesus. In Mark 10:45, it says, "For even the Son of Man did not come to be served, but to serve and to give his life as a ransom for many." I really challenge all of us that this week, huwag natin palang pasin matapos ang linggo ito. Alam ko marami holiday. Let's use the opportunity to serve. Let's do something to serve this week. So for our discussion tonight, I give you two questions I hope you can discuss. For those in Zoom and those who are watching sa Facebook Live, maybe you can give other suggestions also dito sa chat or dun sa comments sa Facebook. But the two questions I want to give you for discussion is this. First, what have you been pursuing lately to give you happiness? Why? I think there may be different things that we're pursuing. Maybe it's a hobby, maybe it's a sport, or maybe it's an activity, or maybe it's something in your job, or something in your school, or something that you're doing. You're trying to be happy and you're pursuing this thing. What is that thing? And why did you think that that would make you happy? And second, what can you do to regularly serve others? Hindi lang yung one time big time, pero yung regular na pwede nating maggawa. Kahit na maliit lang. Mag-serve sa CM, mag-serve sa ushering, tumulong sa pag-set up ng service. Or there are a lot of things that we can do for our church, for our sector, for our brothers and sisters in the church. What's something we can do on a regular basis? So let's have a great discussion that ends the lesson tonight. Let's close out in a word of prayer before we end. Let's pray. Panginoon, maraming salamat po sa inspiration ng galing from the scriptures. It's amazing how the research of psychologists today just confirm what the Bible has written down thousands of years ago. Kino-confirm na kung ano yung sinabi nyo na matagal na. And it's true. The biblical principles of service brings happiness. And when we focus on ourselves, hindi naman talaga kami magiging masaya. Katulungan niyo po kami ma-overcome yung tinuturo sa amin ng buto and follow what the Bible, what God teaches. Help us to have the right pursuit. Help us to have happiness, the real one, the one that lasts. And by doing it your way. So in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you very much for listening.